hello again, everyone. Todd Staruch, the horror nerd here at Scares That Care Charity Weekend number 6 in Williamsburg, Virginia. And I have this, the distinct honor of standing next to horror host extraordinaire and fellow Scares That Care Assistance Award winner, Count Gore Duvall. Count, how are you?
Wow, that's an incredible introduction. Can I copy that down and trademark it?
You absolutely can. I'll write it and I'll send it to you.
Well, okay.
So I made that up on the spot.
That's pretty good. You can hire him to do, you know, jingles and things like, anyway, go ahead.
So Count, you are a fixture here at Scares That Care. And what is it about this particular convention that keeps you so dedicated and coming back?
They asked me.
Okay. Thank you, everybody.
No, seriously. I mean, you know, it's incredible. I mean, people say, well, why don't you do this convention? Why don't you do that convention? Or why don't you do this? It's very simple. They asked. But that's a long time ago. I've been involved with the Scares. This is 6. I've done 5 of the 6. And then prior to that, a lot of the people were involved in Horrifying.
Right.
And they did 13 of those, and I did 12 of the 13. So basically, I've been done 17 of the 19 combined. So yeah, we have a long relationship, a lot of good people. And, you know, I worked with them to work with build a really nice costume contest that's fast and fun. And so that's going on. But why Scares? Hey, look, I'm doing one convention this year, and this is this one because it helps people. Come on, folks. People need help on a personal level, and this convention and the organization does that.
Absolutely, and I have been very proud to be a part of it for so long.
Yes, and you know, what else can you ask for?
Exactly. So I'm looking across the table here about your pictures from over the years. And from a fan perspective, I love meeting everybody, all the personalities. How much fun is it to do what you do? Your outfit, your makeup, you know, it's so cool. How much fun is it?
The makeup, not so much. No, I'm serious. I mean, you think about it. I mean, if you were in a room with celebrities, there must be 20 celebrities in here. I'm the only one in costume. Mm. So it's sometimes it's kind of strange. Every once in a while, as an actor, you'd like to just say, hey, it's me, the actor, and no one really cares. This morning, I was up before I got into costume, and I'm walking around. It was my Clark Kent routine. No one knew me. And you like the anonymity, but on the other hand, hey, look, you're an actor, you like to be recognized, but that's aside. Being a known personality is always a lot of fun.
Are you sometimes surprised at the longevity sometimes that some of these shows and movies have, and that the fans keep coming back after all this time to meet you and talk to you about your work?
If someone had told me 50 years ago that I would still be doing the Count, I would have told them they were absolutely crazy, because I was going to be the next Orson Welles, but that didn't happen. So yeah, actually longevity is interesting. I'm glad that in 1973, when I created this character, I made sure we trademarked it and got recognition from the station that this is mine, anything I create is mine. And because I didn't know that was going to happen, but I figured, what the heck, it's good to have that in your back pocket. So I did put it in my back pocket.
Absolutely. So tell us, what adventures do you have planned for the rest of the year? You digging up any bodies? You working on anything new? What's going on? And how can the fans follow you?
Okay, because I'm excited about this. In October, it'll be the first anniversary of our Roku channel. Now, excellent. You know, I was the first horror host on the internet on July 11th, 1998. Creature Feature, the weekly web program, went on the air, on the internet. We've been doing that every week since 98. But now we're on the big screen. If you have a 100-inch diagonal, you can now watch me. And so every month, at the beginning, we do it a little differently than a lot of other stations. At the beginning of the month, I put on 4 feature films, 4 celebrity interviews, and 2 hosted short films from new and upcoming filmmakers. And it's just perfect so that you don't have to scroll through 500 titles to find out which one you want to watch, and then by the time you get through, it's too late to watch, so you go to bed.
Right.
So anyway, and it's a free channel. It's free. No advertising. You don't have to pay for it. And if you have a Roku box, just go to your search function, put in Count Gore, and by the time you get DE, it'll say, oh, here it is, Count Gore Duvall Presents. You click OK, and there it is. And it's just people are really enjoying it because they're saying, for the longest time, they say, well, it's good you're on the internet, but, you know, we enjoyed you when you used to be on television. Okay, well, that's last century television. So I said, now on your big screen television, you can now watch me again, except big screen and in high def. So it's kind of cool.
That is fantastic. And we will look for that. Look for Count Gore Duvall on Roku, everybody.
Gore Duvall Presents. Yes, okay.
Fantastic. Count, it's always a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks again, and thanks for all the work that you do for Scares That Care. It's great being a part of it with you.
Well, thank you very much, and to all of you, may all your blood be warm.
Count Gore Duvall, everybody, here at Scares the Care Charity Weekend 6 in Williamsburg, Virginia, and we will see all of you in the next interview.